the cup of relief, hopefully for them, they will not get a cup of suffering. For many people, making ends meet during the coronavirus pandemic means cutting back on necessities. But should one's life insurance be on that list? Victor Kiprop takes a closer look at the effect the pandemic has had on life insurance and how players are responding.
Anything can happen. Life can take a turn for the worse at any moment.
It is a conversation that no one is prepared to have. But for Abel Munda, the CEO of Liberty Insurance, it's one that is necessary.
First of all, your greatest asset is your life. If you don't have your life, you can't have anything. That is why we always say that one cannot have a complete financial plan without an life insurance element in it. These critical illnesses that afflict people nowadays, whether it is cancer, whether it is renal failure, whether it is heart attack, I mean, they can just wipe you out in a flash.
The outbreak of COVID-19 earlier this year has further reminded us how fragile life can be and how financially vulnerable we are. And insurers like Liberty have now had to come up with new lifetime critical illness and income protection covers.
So the Kima product essentially is a cover for critical illnesses. That is the unique proposition for that product. So it covers whether it is cancer, whether it is renal failure, whether it is heart attack. There are a number of them, including providing for disability, because some of these illnesses can disable you totally.
But what happens at the expiry of the term?
The beauty about it is, if throughout that period you've not claimed anything, there is money to be refunded to you, which is 10% of the face amount. Again, that is a feature that people really liked, because one of the questions Kenyans like to ask is, you mean I will pay all this money, and if nothing happens to me, at the end of it, I get nothing. So this is where you get something.
The reduction or loss of income due to the pandemic has, however, meant that other basic needs such as food and shelter rank higher in terms of priority. In fact, a number of insurance firms have already reported a sharp rise in policy cancellations and withdrawals by customers who have been squeezed by the tough economic times.
Customers have also obviously been apprehensive. They don't want to meet up. They don't want to consider insurance in this particular. There are other priorities, higher priorities, if I can put it that way. And this is why we see that there has not been any growth.
With 1.72 million workers reported to have lost their jobs between April and June alone due to the COVID-19 induced economic downturn, covers against retrenchment are gaining popularity. A number of clients have also been reported to have taken loans against their policies.
At that point in time in January, people are hard up, people have just come from vacation, and people, you don't have money. So at least you can resort to your policy to enable you to continue to educate your children.
Industry statistics indicate that even before COVID-19 struck, insurance penetration in Kenya was pitiably low, standing at just 2.4% as at the close of 2019. In the meantime, the pandemic is still with us, and Abel says if there were a time to look into your financial planning and future to make sure that you and your family can make the ends meet, the time is now. Victor Kiprop, NTV.